In this video, we will discuss about how to create an application if you have .exe based software. My name is Harender Jangra and welcome to my YouTube channel. So let's discuss about application part in SCCM server. So I have write down some things in this page that we will discuss in this video, along with we will discuss some interview questions that's for application part especially. So let's start. So suppose that you have exe software and you want to create an application for this in your SCCM server. How can you create application if you have .exe based software? So just open your application management and click on applications and right click on application or right click on free space, click on create application. First of all, we will create a template. So just select manually specify the application information, just click on next and provide the name of your application. Before do this, you should have a source file under any particular shared folder. So I have source file under source software and Citrix receiver. In this video, we will create an application for Citrix receiver. I have Citrix receiver media in exe format. So let's create an application for Citrix receiver. How we can do this? So just provide the name Citrix receiver. You can provide publisher name, or this is optional. If you don't want to provide, you can skip. You can provide version. So let me check what is the version of this. So the version is 14.12.0. so let me write down 14.12.0. So just provide the name, version and publisher and just click on next. We don't need to change anything under application catalog, just click on next. Deployment type. What is the deployment type? Deployment type is very important thing where we will define the source file name, what is the path and requirement rule, global condition, detection method, command line, everything we will define under deployment type. But as of now, we are just creating a template, so we will do this later. So just skip this and just simple click on next and click on next. And just click on close. So you can see we have created an application, but we didn't configure anything. As of now, we didn't configure the path of source file and command line, requirement rule, global condition, detection method, anything we didn't configure. So right now we will create a deployment type. Before do this, let's discuss something that comes in our application. So what is deployment type? So deployment type exactly is very important thing. Under deployment type, we will define the command line, we will define the exact path of our media and detection method and requirement rule, global condition, return code, dependency, and these type of thing we define in deployment type. So how can you create deployment type? Simple. First of all, just create a template of any application and after that just right click on application and click on create deployment type. So now we are going to create a deployment type. So let's follow this video and finally we will do these things like import information, general information, requirement, dependency, summary and this type of thing. If you have exe based software, so just select the script installer from this drag and drop option. But if you have MSI file, you just need to select this option and you can choose any option automatically or manually. But if you have exe based software, just select the script installer and choose manually specify the deployment type. Just click on next, provide the deployment type name. Syntax simple, just click on next. Now we will have to provide the path, shows file path in UNC format. So let me provide under sources folder software Citrix receiver, I have exe software. And now just click on installation program and we have to define the exact command line through which we want to install this software in client machine using our SCCM server. So just click on browse and select your exe that is in this shared path and select this exe and click on open. Once you will do this, exactly this is a command line through which our SCCM server will install this software in client machine. But if you want to install this software in silent mode or in any other mode, so you have to provide the parameter, command line parameter. So who will provide the command line parameter? You can Google this or you can ask to application vendor. So let me search, because I want to install the software in silent mode. Citrix receiver command line silent install using SCCM. So you can use, you can find on Google. If you are not able to find this on Google, you can ask to application vendor. Right, you can see if we will use this command line slash silent disable installation dialogs and prompt during installation, means it will install this software in silent mode, it will not ask any prompt etc. So simply use slash silent parameter. So let me use, you can remove these asterisk and just simple provide space and type silent. If you want to use uninstallation command as well, so you have to provide uninstallation command as well. So you can find uninstallation command line as well if you are able to do this. Citrix. If you are not able to find, you can skip. This is optional because we don't want to use uninstallation command. So we just want to install the software in silent mode. So simply we have this command line, and through this command line SCCM server will install the software in client machine. So simply click on next. Now just we are on the detection method, so let's discuss about what is detection method. Detection method is very important thing, and we can use three types of detection method in our SCCM server, in our SCCM in application part. So first of all file system, second registry, and third Windows installer. So this type of detection method we can use in application part. First part is file system. What is the use of file system? So first of all you have to understand about detection method. What is use of detection method? Detection method exactly will detect the application before deployment in client machine. So through this method SCCM will able to find this application is already installed in client machine or not. If the machine have already installed the particular application, so it doesn't make a sense we deploy the software again in the particular machine, right? So we have to define for SCCM server, like for detection of the particular application, how to know, how SCCM can know the application is already installed or not. So through these three files, through these three detection method, SCCM will be able to detect the application is installed or not. So first is file system. Suppose that a particular application is installed, so definitely under program file or program file x86, it will create a particular directory. So let me search this program file x86. This is my physical machine and I have installed Citrix receiver in my physical machine. So there is a folder Citrix and ICA, and you can find on Google as well. All right, like this is a file system detection method and you can use this C program file x86 Citrix ICA client. ICA client. So you can use any file to define this in your SCCM server for detection method. So just click on add clouds and you have three type of detection method. Just file system, registry, Windows installer. File system, you have to provide the file system like the path where exactly it will check. Because we know when this application is installed in a particular machine, it will create a particular directory under C program files or program file x86. So we can provide the exact path. So let me provide this path. This is my SCCM machine. Citrix. I can use any file, so let's copy this path. If you want to use file system, you have to provide the path, like the last DLL file, you just have to cut and paste in file or folder name. Now before installation of this application in client machine, our SCCM will check this file system is present in client machine or not. If this file system is present in client machine, our SCCM will not reinstall this application in the particular machine. So make sure you have provided the correct detection method, otherwise it can create problem. Maybe you will face any problem, your application will get installed successfully, but SCCM will not be able to show this as a success. Or maybe your application is already installed and you have provided wrong detection method. So in that case, our SCCM can try, can retry to install the particular application in targeted machine. So same thing in this application, we have provided file system. You can use below 2.1 as well, like registry, Windows installer. So you can use registry as well, because every application when we install, it will create a particular registry entry. You can use this, and you can use Windows installer as well, because you know when application get installed, it register a Windows product code under your machine, and you can, if you have the product code, you can provide the product code. Our SCCM will identify this application in client machine using this product code. But now we want to use file system, so just choose your file system and just click on OK. Just click on next. User experience, we want to install the software for system, not for user, or whether or not a user is logged in. Just click on next. Requirement is very important thing. What is the requirement? Actually, requirement is a subset of your global condition. Requirement is a subset of your global condition. And what is the global condition? Global condition is a technical condition that you can use to create any application. Like we have multiple type of global conditions are available in our SCCM server. So how can you check? Just click on software library and expand application management. When you expand application management, you will see there is a tab global conditions, and you can see like we have 20 default global condition, and you can use your own created global condition as well. So like we can use this OU organizational. If you want to use organizational unit global condition, means you have two OU under your Active Directory and you want to install this application only on those machines that are belong to a specific OU. So you can use this global condition to create an application. So it will not install application in other machine where our machine belongs to different OU. We can use CPU speed, device type, disk space, number of processor, operating system. So these type of things we can use. So just click on requirement and click on add, and now we have all global conditions are available. You can use any type or you can create your own. So just click on custom and you can click on create. So you have to provide which type of condition you want to create, like registry based, assembly, file system, like which type. So I want to use our already created global conditions. So just choose device and click on condition and click on choose your condition that you want to use. For example, I want to use operating system one of none of. Like I want to install this application in Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 8.1 and Windows 10. If you want to install this application only on Windows 7 32, you just select all Windows 7 32. Or if you want to install in 32 as well in 64, you can choose all. So I want to install the software in Windows 7, 8, 8.1 and 10. So I have selected this and click on OK. You can use other requirement rule as well and just click on next. Dependency, what is the dependency? So dependency exactly suppose that any particular application that you are going to create require any other application to being installed. So in that case you can create a separate package for its dependency and you can add that package under this application, but you will have to create package or application for the dependency, then only you can use the dependency tab. I don't want to use any dependency as of now, so just select next. This is my summary that I have selected. Click on next. Just click on close. We have created an application with one deployment type and you can see the history. Click on deployment type and you can review the property of your deployment type. If you want to change anything, like under general content, if you want to change the path, if you want to change the command line that you have used, or if you want to add or remove an installation command line, detection method, user experience, if anything you want to add or remove, you can read the property. So we have created an application for exe based software. Now if we want to deploy this software, before deployment we have to distribute the content on DP. So simple, right click on this and click on distribute content. Just click on next, click on next and just click on add. Choose your DP, and my test environment I just have one DP. Just click on OK, click on next, next and click on close. So just right click on and refresh, and you have to wait. Once our application will get success in DP, you will see the green icon. Under green icon you can see one. As of now we can see this is in progress. So let's discuss something new feature like supersedence, revision, simulate deployment, retire and deployment. So what is the supersedence? Supersedence means for that a particular application supersede by any other application and you want to deploy newly application on your client machine, but you want to uninstall or upgrade your existing application that has been superseded. So in that case, you can define a relationship with your existing application. So suppose that this is my application that has superseded any other application. So let me show you, maybe we have any other application. For example, we have WinZip application, and WinZip application has been superseded by Citrix receiver. So in that case, you want to uninstall WinZip application and you want to install Citrix receiver. So how you can define supersedence? Just click on property and click on supersedence and just click on add and choose your application that has been superseded. So for example, I'm taking WinZip application, so just click on OK. Now you have to define the relationship path, like what do you want to with this application. Do you want to uninstall? So a new deployment type would be Citrix, and just choose your, and do you want to uninstall this application on client machine? Yes. So just click on OK. So you have to provide, but we don't want to add because WinZip application is not superseded by Citrix. So you can use this tab. The next feature is revision. What is the use of revision? Like when you change anything in your application, a new revision will create. Suppose that if now we can see the revision number is 2. So for example, we want to change anything. So just right click on this and suppose that I have changed something, like I have changed software version 14.12. So just click on apply and just click on OK. So now you can see the revision has changed. Now we can see the revision is 3. So every time when you change anything, a new revision will create and you can see the history. Just right click on this and click on revision history. So you can restore, you can view, you can delete any revision. For example, if you want to view your second revision, so just select the second revision and just click on view. Now you can see we have 14.12.0 version is available in this. If you want to restore this, you can use this option. And let's check this 3, just click on view. Now we can see under 3 revision we have 14.12 version. So same thing, when anything change, a new revision will create and you can use, you can see history of your revision. The next thing is simulate deployment. Simulate deployment exactly the very important thing, and it will check what is use of simulate deployment. Simulate deployment means we want to deploy this application virtually. Virtually means in actual we don't want to install this application, we just want to check the application will work correctly or not in client machine. So in that case you can use simulate deployment. And under simulate, when you simulate deployment, what it will check? It will check detection method, and it will check requirement rule, and it will check dependency. So these things our SCCM will check when you deploy this application as a simulate. But make sure you should make sure you didn't deploy this application, means you didn't set any active deployment for this application if you want to simulate. So our SCCM will just check the under deployment type that we have defined, like detection method, requirement rule and dependency. These three things our SCCM will check on client machine. It will not check this command line if you have provided wrong command line as well. So it will, but if you have provided the detection method, requirement and dependency is correct, so our deployment, simulate deployment, will get success. Now the next feature is retire. Retire, what is use of retire? Suppose that a particular application you don't want to use in future, so you can set this as a retire. Just right click on this and click on retire. Now you cannot use this application for further deployment until you reinstate this application, right? Now you can see the status is retired, means no further active deployment can be made for this application. But we want to use this application, so simply just right click on this and click on reinstate. Now we can set any active deployment for this application. And suppose that you have set this application as a retire, so after 2 or 3 months automatically your SCCM will delete this application from your SCCM server. The next thing is deployment. Now you can deploy this application. So how you can deploy? So simple, right click on this and click on deploy and click on browse. Choose your device collection, provide your collection where you want to deploy. For example, I want to deploy this application on all system. Next. Now what do you want? Like, do you want to install or uninstall? Uninstall will work only when you have defined uninstallation command line, but we didn't configure uninstallation command line, so we will choose install. And under purpose you have two options, available and required. Available means this application will be available on client machine. If user want to install this application, they have to click on install button, otherwise this application will be available on software center only. Required means on a specific given time this application will be installed forcefully in the machine. So we want to use this application as a available, so just select this and click on next. If you will not select any time, this application will be available as soon as possible, so simply click on next. User experience, what do you want to what notification do you want to show to user? So I want to show all notification to a user, display in software center and show all notification. Click on next. This is my summary. You can read the summary and you can share the summary with your management before make a active deployment, and your manager will verify this, and after that you can go further. Just click on next and click on close. Now we have made a active deployment for this application on all system with available purpose. So this is my client machine. Let's run machine policy, our client machine, application deployment. Okay, software center. As of now we can see the only one application is available in this machine, so let's wait. You can review some of the log files, like this is the name of my client machine, Win7 new. Okay, what is the name? right? We can see the notification came, new software is available, and if user will click on this notification, automatically your software center will open in client machine and you can see the detailed information. So under application we can see we have two application available in this machine. So just as a end user, just simple, just click on this application. If user want to install this application, he can click on install button. So I want to install this application, so simply click on install and let's wait. Now it's downloading and it's installing. Post downloading it will install this application and where exactly it will store. When it download the content from distribution point, it will store this file media in C drive, Windows and under CCM cache. So you have to check the today date 26 and you can see this media has been downloaded in this path H. So now we can see the status get filled. So simply click on this. If you see this message, your application is getting filled with this error code 0x87d00324. It means you didn't provide it your detection method correct, right? You have to correct your detection method. So let's check. So simply open your deployment type property and click on detection method and just choose your detection method and check. So we have provided this detection method C program file x86 citrix ca client. So first of all let's check our application is installed or not. So we can see in this machine our application have successfully installed, but in software center we are not seeing as a success. It's getting failed because our detection method is not working properly. So let's check our detection method is creating or not as per provided that detection method that we have provided. It's not creating because this machine is x64, right? Oh, I'm sorry, this machine is 32-bit. So that's why in this machine we don't have any program file x86. So if you have 32-bit operating system, you are not able to see program file x86. So that's why our detection method is not able to create program file x86. It cannot see there. So we have to provide correct detection method, or you can add any other. So simple click on add clouds and you can provide any other detection method. So let's create on this. So we can use this detection method in our machine. So let's add one more detection method. Just click on add clouds and choose file system and just copy your DLL file. Any file you can take this and just click on OK. Now we have to change AND OR. We have to change with OR because if any condition is matching, our application should get installed and should show success, right? If we will use AND, it means both condition should be matched, and it's not possible to match both condition in a single machine, right? So simple, choose your OR and just click on apply. We have changed something, so revision got changed and now we have to update content so that it can change on distribution point. So you can click on retry. Again, it's getting failed. So we have to wait some time. Now we can see this is getting filled with different error code 1603. So generally this error code comes when we can see like a fatal error we can see. So simply you can restart this machine or you can retry. Getting loud. So you can review some of the log files. Like if you have installed a particular application in any machine and you want to track using log files in client machine. So you can review some of the log files in client machine. So just open your client machine cdollar. Let me check what is the name. Win7 new. Okay. The IP address is 077. So we have opened cdollar of our client machine and just click on Windows and click on CCM and logs. This is the folder where we can see some of the log files for application troubleshooting point of view. So first of all, you have to read appdiscovery.log. Through appdiscovery.log, we can read like this application is already installed or not. So now we can see the entering XQR sync and the performing detection of app deployment type Citrix. So the deployment has came in this machine and now it's detecting the application is available, is installed or not. So if you are able to see this message application not discovered and did not detect app deployment type, it means the particular application is not installed in this machine, right? And the second log file you can read appintenttable.log. So under appintenttable.log you can read this log file in two manner. First of all, you can read this log file for dependency installation status, like app intent eval.log will tell us exactly the suppose that this particular application has any dependency. So it will check the dependency is installed or not. If this application doesn't have any dependency, so it will show us like this message, no dependencies for deployment type. And after that we can use this log file for final installation status. Like post installation, if you see this status, current status compliant, and the Citrix receiver is installed and current status is compliant, means this application got installed successfully in our client machine. So now you can open Citrix and you can see our application get installed successfully without any error code. And you can review some of the log files, appinfos.log and cache.log. Cache.log, through cache.log you can review where it has been downloaded, or it has it downloaded successfully or not. And you can see the content is available under C, Windows, System, Cache and H, like jahan pe bhi, where it have been downloaded the folder, exactly your media. And further you can review some of the other log file as well, like appinfos.log. Appinfos.log is very important log file, and through which you can see the installation status. Like we can see the application got failed with this error code 1603, it's considered an execution failure. You can press Ctrl L and you can type your error code, and you can see like this is fatal error code, right? And first of all, we have failed this machine. Right, so now we have installed this application successfully, and you can see app infos completed, okay, with this command line that we have provided. So these log file you can review to troubleshooting any application. Now let's come on. So finally we have learned about how to create an application if we have .exe based software, and we have discussed these features in this video. And let's come on our second page, where I have mentioned some interview questions that generally asked by any interviewer, like what is difference between packages and application. So you can review this questions, and what is global condition, what is supersedence, retire and revision in application, client side log files, what is deployment type, and what is detection method. These things we already have discussed, and just this question we didn't discuss, what is difference between packages and application. So you can Google it, or you can wait my second video where I will mention the answer of this question. Thank you guys for watching my video. Please share and please subscribe my channel.